Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel Data Sculptor. Today we are going to cover another interesting SQL question. So this was asked in FRACTAL data analyst interview. So we have some Game of Thrones data sets. So the first table at the top, you see this table is battles. We have all the battles data. You have the battle number, name, attacker king, defender king, attacker outcome and region. And below is the king's data. You have the king and the house. And this is the output which is expected. So now let's go back to SQL Server Studio and see what is the logic behind this output. So what logic we need to apply to get this output, and what is the query that is required to get this output. So if you're watching our channel for the first time, make sure you hit the like button and also the subscribe button. So now let's go back to SQL Server Studio. So as discussed, we have these two tables, king and battle. And king, the columns are k underscore number, king and house. And here primary key, k number is the primary key. And also you have the battle table. Battle number is the primary key, name, attacker king, defender king, attacker outcome and region. So the question is, for each region, you have to find the house which has won the maximum number of battles. And you have to display the region, house and number of wins. So this is the question. So now let's see how to write the query behind this. So first thing, if you observe the battles data, you have the battle number, which is the primary key. And for a question, this is of no use. And the name, and battle name is also of no use. But the columns, attacker king and defender king. So these both are referring to the king table. So attacker king, one is a, so here it is one. So it is house Stark. And here defender king, here the value is 2. So here it is house Lannister. And the attacker outcome is 1. That when the attacker outcome is 1, that means the attack, the battle is won by the attacker. So if the attacker outcome is 0, that means the battle is won by the defender. So using this data, now we have to find the number of wins for each house in each region. So how do we find that? So the first thing you need to do is, first you need to join the battle and the king based on the attacker king column. So select from battle B, left join king K on B dot attacker king is equal to K dot K underscore number, where attacker outcome is equal to 1. So when you write this query, let's see what we are getting. So we are joined the battle table and the king table based on the attacker king column, and the attacker outcome value is 1. So when you run this, this is what the output you get. So I have filtered out for attacker outcome 1, because here based on this filtering, we can decide that these battles are won by the attacker king. That means these battles are won by this particular house. So here what all columns we will take? We will take the region, comma, house, comma, comma, battle number. So battle number we are just keeping to understand, so to differentiate the data. So in this, when the attacker outcome is 1, the house, here the whatever value we are keeping in our house, that is the team that has won the battle. And now what I will do, I will create one more query, same query, from bat, I will join the battle and king, but this time I will join based on the defender king column. So from battle B, left join king K on B dot defender king is equal to K dot K underscore no, where attacker outcome is equal to 0. So wherever the attacker outcome is 0, that means here the defender king has won. So that's why we are joining with defender king, and on the attacker outcome is equal to 0. And here again we will pull all this columns. So when you run this query, you will get these all battles 2, 4, 6 and 8, and in these regions these are the teams that have participated, and these all are the defenders. So these are the teams that won. So now what I will do, in this first query you got the data where the attackers have won for each battle, and here you got the output where the defenders have won for each battle. So when you union this, you need to make sure that this entire data has all the battles data. So whether which team has won each battle. So 1, 2, 8. So all the 8 battles should be coming in this data. So if you see here, the battle number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. All the battles data is coming. And in each of the battle, we have the house and we have the team which has won. Okay. So this is the main data, and we'll keep this in CTE with CTE S. Okay. So in this CTE, we have for each battle and which region, I mean for each battle and region, which house has won the battle. So the question is, now for each region, you need to find which house has won the maximum number of battles. So for north, the north, which house has won the maximum number of battles, and for the reach, which house has won the maximum number of battles, and for riverlands, we need to find the house. Okay. So to get that, what we'll do first, for each and every region and house, we'll calculate the total number of battles won. So select region, comma house, comma count of 1 as total underscore wins from CTE, group by region, comma house. So this will give us the total number of wins for each house in each region. Okay. So this data set we have received for each region and each house, how many are the total number of wins. But this is not the output we want. We want for each region, the house which has won the maximum wins. So what we'll have to do, we'll create one more row number column. So we'll create a rank, we'll create a row number such that the for each region, we'll assign our row number to the house based on the total wins. So row number over partition by region, order by count of 1 in descending order. So partition by region gives us each region. This will take a subset of each and every region. So first, if you take the riverlands, you will have a house Baratheon 2 wins and house Stark 1 win. So this first row should be assigned a value of 1, and the second row should be assigned a value of 2. Okay, and as RN. So now if you run this, this is what you get. So for each and every region, you are assigned a row number. So 1, 2. And here, since it is a match, you will anyway return 1 and 2. But here row number will not satisfy requirement, because since there is since the highest is the equal number of wins, we cannot use a row number. So here we want to return the data where both, I mean, if there is a match, we have to return both the rows. So in this case, instead of row number, we have to use the dense rank function. Okay. So now if we run this query, this is what you get. So for north, you have a house Stark, and for reach, you have both the houses, and for riverlands, you have the top house. And now in this data set, I will filter out Rn is equal to 1. I'll apply a filter in the where condition where Rn is equal to 1. So I cannot directly write Rn is equal to 1 in the where condition, because we should not write, window function should not be written in the where condition. So I'll keep this in another CTE, CTE 2 as this, whatever data we have, and here select region, comma house, comma total underscore wins from CTE 2, where Rn is equal to 1. Okay. So when you run this query, this is what you are getting. For each and every region, you are getting the house which has the highest number of wins. So in this way, we have to write the query. So the main part here is, you need to understand how to join the battle and king. So you have to filter out, for each and every battle, you need to create a table indicating which battle is won by which house. So once you are ready with the data, you can do whatever calculations are required. So that's it. So that's it from today's video. So if you have liked this question and also liked my explanation, please click on the like button and also click on subscribe button to get more videos. And if you want to practice more SQL questions, please watch all the videos present in the description. So I have a multiple playlist present in the description of this video. So you have a lot of questions, over 100 questions on SQL. So I suggest you to practice all those questions. And in the comment section, you can comment out whatever question or whatever solution you have. So let's meet in the next video. Till then, thank you. Have a nice day.